Hindi ko maintindihan kung anong pinagsasabi niya.
But this particular...
I have not read the affidavit so that I would not be in a position to correctly really respond to your question. I am at a loss kasi ikaw yung may hawak ng... So you are now trying to investigate me. Para kang investigador. Yung may hawak ka ng affidavit dyan, executed by another person, trying to confront me with the statements made in that affidavit, and you're trying to exact an answer from me. Pagka ganon, maghinto tayo dito. That is not proper.
Mr.
That
President.
Is not fair.
Mr. President, we're not...
Titindig ako dito. Bigyan mo muna ako ng...
Sir, sir.
Yung mga affidavit, basahin ko before I answer you.
Suspended, sir.
Huwag ka na maghanap ng iba. Ano yung 7-7 mo? Dito ko nalang tutok sa akin. Ilan ko pang beses sabihin sa inyo, I take full responsibility. If you think that it is illegal or wrong, go ahead and file the case. I would be happy.
If I understand correctly, there should at least be one master list. Automated says. In fact, I remember one press con in which you mentioned the mayor.
Talk slower because I cannot understand you.
Oh, sorry.
Frankly, you're a lawyer?
Yes, Mr. President. Oh, I will talk slower.
Panero, you talk slower. Okay. Maybe maganda ka ang English mo, pero fortunately, hindi na iintindihan.
Thank you, Mr. President. I will slow down. So, Mr. President.
You are slurring your words there.
Mr. President,
follow. If that answer the question that you're answering, then maybe I got to hear you right. Ganon ang dating sa akin.
Sobrang nakakagulat na balita. Grabe, former President Rodrigo Roa Duterte, pinatigil na ang Kongreso, napilitang huminto, napilitang magsuspende ang Congress. Ayon sa nakalap nating impormasyon, nyanig ni Duterte ang Kongreso. Sinermona ni Duterte si Congressman Rog Gutierrez. Tinanong kasi siya sa mga kaso, nagulat sinagot siyang hindi ka judge, doon tayo maglaban sa korte. Nagulat pinatigil ni Duterte ang Kongreso, napilitang magsuspende ang mga congressman, napilitang huminto ang Congress. Tara panoorin natin.
The next interpreter is Congressman Rog Gutierrez. You have 10 minutes.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. Mr. Chair, before I receive my interpellation, simple manifestation. This representation has noticed that the good former president is more comfortable in a conversational manner of speaking. With that, I'd like to move if the committee and the rules would allow, I'd like to waive the rule that he cannot speak while I'm speaking. So as not to hinder him, I want the former president to have an unhindered and unadulterated chance to give his statement. So with that, should the good former president understand, I will yield the floor at any time that he wishes to speak. I just hope that he would perhaps signal me by perhaps raising his hand. And at any time, I will stop talking to allow him to continue his speech. So as to avoid any overlapping. If that is fine, I will proceed, Mr.
I'm sure the former president heard you loud and clear, Congressman Gutierrez.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Mr. Chairman, I'd like to direct my questions to the former president, Rodrigo Roa Duterte. Mr. President, good afternoon po. Before I proceed with my line of question, I'd like to pick up on some points that some of my colleagues have mentioned earlier. Most recently, Mr. President, the Congresswoman Luis Tro was driving a point regarding full responsibility, and I'd just like to follow up on that. Nabanggit po ninyo, in the context of the war on drugs, that you will take full responsibility, full legal and moral responsibility, if I'm not mistaken, was your statement. And you said this in the context that you would be taking care of the Philippine National Police. However, Congresswoman Luis Tro has also mentioned a string of cases in which were allegedly part of the war on drugs, which are conducted in manner of extrajudicial killing. When it came to those points, Mr. President, you mentioned that you will not take responsibility. And what comes to mind is your statement in the Senate in which you had an argument with the senator. You had a statement with the senator in which you said that guilt is personal. So, Mr. President, my question to the Honorable Chairman is which po ba? When we are referring to the war on drugs, you say that you take responsibility for the policy, yet you will not take responsibility pag nagka-leche-leche in your terms, yung ating mga kapulisan. Would you care to elaborate, Mr. President?
Nothing is perfect in this world. When the police go to an operation, there are guidelines, strict guidelines that they follow. But sometimes things go awry. Nasusubrahan, nasisira yung nire-raid ng na bahay, o persons are arrested at that time, which are not really connected with the activity there. Pero hindi mo maiwasan eh. You know, trabaho ng police kasi, I'm not trying to protect them. But as a matter of policy, I have to understand what I... Kasi talagang ginigipit ko ang police magtrabaho. So, kung meron silang medyo kasalanan, but in the performance of that order, talagang this is my moral and legal obligation because I gave the order. Then I have to protect them because that is my responsibility. Hindi ko pwede hindi ko pwedeng bitawan yung tao. Kasi pag sinabi mo sa police, trabahuin mo ito, tapos stricto ka, gusto mo talagang gaya mo, if you want to make the city peaceful, gawain mo yan, make the city peaceful, I do not care paano mo gawin, basta gawain mo ang city ko peaceful. When that is the time na kung sabihin mo masabit sila pag gamali, talagang papasok ako. Because I gave the order. So, I in a sense, I take full responsibility if there is any. Akin yan. And should I be included in the charge or charges? Yes. I'd be willing to go to court, explain, and if it is not legal, according to the judge, or insufficient, wala tayong magawa. Makunong tayo. Trabaho eh. Trabaho yan.
Mr. President, to the Honorable Chairman, so you are now making a distinction. When you say you take full responsibility, you're talking about the policy consideration, the orders that you've given the PNP. However, you would make a distinction as to individual cases in which you would claim you would not know.
Alam mo kasi, sir, pag sinabi mo, campaign against drug, I mean, as president, ginawa ko yan. It does not mean to say that you are free to kill if you are free to rob and rape. Pag sinabi kong campaign against drug, you do it as a police officer. Nag-aral ka naman ng 2 years basic. Sinunod mo lahat, you should follow. Not if you go out of the way, I cannot answer for you. Kung ano yung sa isip mo, bakit mo ginawa yan, only you can answer that question. Pero yung policy nakikita ng tao, eh talagang akin yan. Pag sinabi ng pumasok yung mga police doon at pinilit nila yung pumasok ng isang building, so if there is any liability, hindi kasali na ako. Hindi na ako naghuhugas ng gamay.
So, Mr. President, from your statement relating to the policy consideration, you take full responsibility at least for example, collateral damage in legitimate police operations.
Yes.
That is one of the examples.
Kasali na yan.
However, Mr. President, I believe, just to pinpoint, para mas klaro, one of the cases mentioned by Honorable Congresswoman Luistro was that of the PCSO Corporate Secretary at General Barayuga. And for your enlightenment, Mr. President, the reason it was conducted, according to the witness, si Colonel Santi Mendoza, is that he did it in the name of your order. He did it in the name of your war on drugs. Allegedly, he was given the order to conduct the hit, and it was part of the war on drugs. So, what we see from that testimony, Mr. President, to the Honorable Chairman, is that because of your order and because of your statements and pronouncement, it has emboldened the police force to conduct these operations. And although you might not have personal knowledge of the same, and you might have not given the personal order, your subordinates, through the Chief PNP, through Colonel Leonardo, have allegedly conducted these operations. Now, in relation to that, you said that you will not take full responsibility for that case because you have no consideration. You have no participation as such. How now do we reconcile your acknowledgement of full responsibility for policy orders versus what is happening on the ground, Mr. President?
You know, when I say that I faith, I have faith in the police, when I order them to do something, kailangan, pagka may nagkamali dyan, may masagutin mo rin. Huwag mong, do not leave them hanging. Somebody has to say that I was the one who ordered. And if there was something that went wrong, then I have also to answer for it. But you do not go into a campaign, you do not go into a drive for nothing. It is always a legitimate government action.
So in this case, Mr. President, in the case of the Barayugas Lay, in which the witness, Colonel Mendoza, mentioned that he conducted it in the belief that it was part of legitimate police operations under the orders of his superior, Colonel Leonardo, this was under your directive in the war on drugs. Yet you said you will not take responsibility when you were asked by Congresswoman Luisto. So that, I repeat the question, Mr. President, with all due respect, how do we now reconcile? You're taking full responsibility for the policy consideration, yet when it comes to the individual cases where policemen are left hanging, for your information, Mr. President, si Colonel Santi Mendoza made this statement. He is still currently serving as a police colonel. He is a working policeman po. Hindi po siya sinipa, hindi po siya tinanggal. He made this statement against his own interest. So how now do we reconcile? Where do you draw the line of your responsibility in this war on drugs, Mr. President?
Because guilt is personal. Ano, pagka nagkabinaril ka dyan, it's always personal. So in that sense, hindi mo talaga sasagutin dyan because what is, ano ang nasa isip niya? Eh kung sabihin mo, drive lang, eh pati yung tao dyan nakaupo lang, barilin mo, eh that is something, o lumaban. Pero kung sabihin mo, ako ang nag-utos, I take full responsibility sa ng what happened. So, if there is a case that is going to be filed, you can file the case against me, including the erring policeman. I will not exempt myself. Hindi ako nagbibitin ng tao. So, kasali ako dyan. O sige, i-demanda mo kami. File a case in court at kaso tayo.
Thank you, Mr. President. Just a short manifestation before I proceed with the rest of my questioning.
Kasi,
I would like to...
ganun na rin. Pag may magsabi ko, sige, mag-conduct tayo ng operation. Pag nakabulyaso yan, rightly or wrong, or pag sabihan, utos kasi ni Mayor. Hindi, huwag mo bitinin yung tao. Kasi hindi naman lahat ng police talagang bright. But the fact that they were there in pursuance to your order for a legitimate purpose, maybe to stop smuggling or raid a laboratory there somewhere. Ganon.
Well, thank you for that clarification, Mr. President. But as I mentioned, to continue my manifestation, for the consideration of the committee, it would be hard for us to take the statement that the former president would take full legal and moral responsibility, yet at the same time insist guilt is personal. I hope this is something that we consider taking statements moving forward. And I think, Mr. President,
that's a principle of law, kasi guilt is personal, that is not mine. But when I say I take full responsibility, meaning to say, if there is going to be an accounting for the actions of the police, you can include me because I gave the order. Pero yung kasi sabihin mong guilt, because guilt is personal, hindi mo mapasa yan sa akin. But the order, sabihin mo yung order ng mayor, akin yan, that is different. Kung ano yung individual guilt doon, hindi, kung sabihin mo, overall, nakabulyaso yan, akin yan. At hindi ko, in many cases, mayor for almost 30 years, and even as president, when I ordered na ano, tinuturo ko talaga sarili ko, akin yan. para magtrabaho ang mga tao.
Thank you, Mr. President, for the
Somebody
clarification.
Somebody has to take the blame. At the blame stops here.
Thank you, Mr. President. Yet, Mr. Chair, I repeat my manifestation that the confusion between the statement that there will be full legal responsibility and at the same time guilt is personal. While there's the mentioning that he will take full responsibility in the cases of, for example, the Barayugas Lay, and of course, also the killing of the three Chinese nationals. I would like to mention that in the case of the Davao Penal Colony, that according to our witnesses, your name was also utilized, Mr. President. Ang sabi po ni Colonel Garm, allegedly, if I believe you're right, is that huwag kayo mag-interfere. Alam ng presidente ito. This is part of. Alam mo naman yung pinaglalaban natin dito. So that is just some of the examples, Mr. President, which we have to decipher the difference now between your pangako po, your taking charge, full responsibility, versus what you're saying na guilt is personal. But nevertheless, Mr. President, we'll proceed with the rest of the line of questioning. Mr. President, you made a statement prior, and I think this was brought up by Congressman Abante, regarding sa helicopter po. And I think you affirmed this. You mentioned that if you are corrupt, I will fetch you using a helicopter to Manila and I will throw you out. I have done this before. Why would I not do it again? And you mentioned, Mr. President, earlier that this is hyperbole. You said, istorya lang po. You stand by this, Mr. President, through the Honorable Chairman.
Patakot lang man yun.
Patakot. And at this time, this was at a formal event po, no? You made this statement while you were already president. Was that correct?
Yes.
And you would often make use of hyperbole and historia na panakot, whether it's in a speech, whether it's a media press conference, and you would choose no. There's no distinction between formal and informal events in your utilization of such stories.
Yes.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. Mr. President, with that said, how do we reconcile sometimes that you would say, and I think just a manifestation, there were some mentioning of the previous administration that actually the job of the presidential spokesperson was the presidential translator. Minsan po, there had to be a distinction when you were joking or not. Yet, when you were giving your orders to the PNP, for example, would you also utilize hyperbole sometimes or historia?
Directa ako. In a command conference, directa ako. Ano, lahat na sila, tanong ka. Ano, pag sabi ko, trabaho mo yan, trabaho mo. Ang akin kasi ganito, ayaw ko ng kriminal. Kung mapatay mo isang kriminal na lumaban, one less headache for humanity. Pag may isang drug into traffic na lumaban, napatay mo, one less headache for society. Ang akin dyan is just the process of elimination and minimizing the danger to society. Pagka marami yan sila, then walang mangyari. Yari mayor ni presidenta, hayaan mo yung mga sindikato dyan na to flourish. Kung hindi matakot yan, patayin mo, wala talaga mangyari rin. Walang mangyari sa siyudad mo, walang mangyari sa Pilipinas.
Thank you, Mr. President. Mr. President, to the Honorable Chairman, I'd like to ask, in relation to that, your questions, I mean, your answers and statements given today, were some of them hyperbole, or were all of them matter-of-fact frank, as you would give in your command conference?
Well, minsan, hindi ako nag-ano, hindi ako nagbibigay talaga ng direkta na ano. I would leave it hanging so that you will have something to think of.
Well, Mr.
Wala
President,
wala kasing tao magsay na ako ang pumatay ni Kilsan. I and I alone. Walang gagawin tao na ganyan. You play with words. But when you are in government, and you are there in the performance of duty to keep your city or to keep your country at least safe sa mga tao against the criminals, you have now the dilemma of whether or not to side with the innocent people and maybe victims or itong mga criminals. I have no second thoughts. Wala akong duda kung saan ako pupunta. Dito ako pupunta sa tao, kaya maganda ang siyudad ko when I became mayor. maganda ang Davao. Yung na-presidente ako, minus-minus ang sindikato. Kasi alam ng mga tao, pinatay ko sila.
Mr. President, thank you for being candid. And you just mentioned now that sometimes you admitted, even in this proceedings that we have, that you would mention things that are hyperbole. However, Mr. President, I would like to respectfully remind you, to the Honorable Chairman, that you are under oath. And I think the play on words would have to be at a minimum because anything that you say here will be taken at its face value. With that said, Mr. President, I'd like to reiterate that reminder with the rest of my following questions. I hope there would be no hyperbole, and I hope that this made understood.
I welcome any accusations in court in connection with this and other proceedings which I gave the same statement.
Thank you. Mr. President, my next few questions.
Trabaho ko yun?
Yes.
Trabaho ko yun.
My line of questioning will not be accusations. Actually, I will just be asking you about statements that you've made earlier to confirm whether or not they were hyperbole and the facts surrounding the same. So with that, I'd be proceeding, Mr. Chairman. Mr. President, earlier, Chairman Dan Fernandez had this question, and you affirmed that when you were mayor, you would go around in your motorcycle and you would be looking for trouble, literally looking for these criminals. And you mentioned that sometimes you would find them and you would kill them. Was that hyperbole, Mr. President?
Not necessarily. Yung encuentro lang. Nakamotor ako, pagbababa ako, yun o. Magparking ako, tapos lapitan ko sila. Yung iba magtakbo, yung iba hindi. Minsan, may makita ako na magbunot ng baril. Eh, lumalaban. Hindi naman ako masyado praktisado sa barilan, pero alam ko na pag ganun ang sitwasyon, you're in danger of losing your life.
Mr. President, in these times na rumuronda po kayo naka big bike and you've had these encounters, how many persons have you killed, Mr. President?
Wala akong accounting dyan.
With no hyperbole, Mr. President, would you know?
Wala talaga akong Maybe 3-4, gano'n. Yung direct talaga na encuentro.
3/4 of what po, Mr. President?
Again?
You mentioned 3/4 or 3 or 4?
Hindi, ibig sabihin ko. Iba-ibang situation.
But I mean, how many have you killed, Mr. President? These situations?
3 or 4, something like that.
3 or 4 incidents. And in these 3 or 4 incidents, Mr. President, were they all caught in flagrante delicto, meaning they were in commission of the crime?
I would never kill an innocent. Hindi ako gago magbaril ng tao. Sabi mo nakatali, yung extrajudicial killing niya, sabi mo na nakapusas tapos baril. Hindi ka lalaki niya.
Thank you for the clarification.
That's not a job. Huwag na lang yung sabihin nung tanggalin mo na lang yung mayor tapat yung pagkapulis mo. Hindi, that's not a job. Pagkalalaki ka, hindi mo gawin yan.
So, Mr. Chair, they were caught in flagrante delicto, meaning in the commission of the crime, at you would say na in all these cases, nanlaban po sila, yung 3 or 4. Bumunot po sila ng baril.
Yes. Sa dumoy.
Mr. President, in these 3 or 4 cases of...
Ang problema lang yan is, actually, 6 ba yun ang namatay? 4 lang ang baril. So, ibig sabihin, hindi lahat nakahawak. But the problem is, when there is shoot out, ang bala naman hindi talaga namimili. So if you are concentrated on one space, tapos nagputok ka na, mabuti sana kung isang bagbang. Eh kung armalite,
So, Mr. President, you're saying in these instances of your vigilante nights na nakabike po kayo, minsan may collateral damage po?
Wala.
None?
Wala.
So, in these 3 or 4 cases that you mentioned na may pinatay po kayo na nanlaban, were cases filed against you for homicide?
Wala.
Isn't it the job of the prosecutor to, if pag may namatay, either homicide or murder, that they would file the case and you would prove your defense in court?
Si Pael, yung prosecutor, bakit niya? Ako na ngayon, nanlaban, tapos ako ba i-prosecute mo?
So, Mr. President, in these instances where you killed these 3 and 4 people, and wala, no cases were filed?
No. No cases were filed.
Would you recall the names of these persons that you have killed?
No. You know, why would I? It's a silly question. Bakit ba alamin kung sino yung gagawin na yan? Punerari ang bahala na sila mag-establish ng identity. And the police. Not me.
Mr. Chair, just a manifestation. It is deeply disturbing to know that there's a confession of killing here in which the prosecutor did not investigate. There were no cases were filed, not even before the DOJ. I believe this is something that should be brought up to the attention of the DOJ and should be studied at a further time. Thank you, Mr. Chair.
I'm waiting for that time. I'd be happy. I would be happy to answer any and all. Walang problema yan.
Thank you for that. Mr. President, you also mentioned earlier kay Chairman Dan, and I think to other congressmen, that marami na po kayong police na pinatay. And I would assume that this is in reference to certain malicious or yung mga ninja cops. Would you have a number kung ilan po ito? Without hyperbole, Mr. President, ilan po ang police ang pinatay po ninyo personally?
Hindi lang ako. Yung police, in a raid, something like that. Shootout.
In a raid, in a shootout.
Hindi yung sabihin mo na confrontation personal na one-on-one.
Mr. President, what was your participation in the raid or shootout? As a mayor, you were there for the police operation?
Yes.
And this is a one-time thing po ba, Mr. President, or it has happened multiple times?
What?
Maraming beses na po ba ito nangyari?
Under.
So it was only one raid in which maraming police ang pinatay? Would you have a date in mind, or is there a name for this incident that there would be, that you could recall, Mr. President?
About what?
About that raid in which may marami po kayong pinatay na police.
Hindi police ang pinatay ko. May ano tayo dito. Tayo nakaiintindihan.
Miscommunication. Okay, Mr. President. Well, I'll just proceed in another question.
Hindi ako nagpapatay ng police ko.
Okay.
I would never do that. Well, sa bagay, may mga police na into kidnapping.
Perhaps yun po yun, Mr. President, because I remember the context of the conversation was mga police na scallywag or yung mga ninja cops. And you mentioned that you would not tolerate the same.
Yes.
So in which case, Mr. President, how many of those have you killed? I would assume the 3 to 4 that you mentioned earlier in your vigilante nights were just regular criminals. And iba naman po ang iyong tally for mga police na mga scallywag.
Matanong man ninyo sa Davao, mga 2 or 3.
2 or 3.
Involved in kidnapping.
Kidnapping po ito. And these did not...
Paghawak ng pera.
Mr. President.
Lalo na paghawak ng pera patapos i-rape pa yung mga babae. Talagang wala ka ng pag-asa. Huwag na tayong magsabi extra judicial. O pagkatapos ka maghanak ka o hawak mo ang pera, i-rape mo ang mga babae. Pag nandyan ako sa dandan, huwag na natin pag-usapan yung extrajudicial killing. Patayan talaga yan.
So, Mr. President, the story that you're saying now, yung mga police na scallywag na 2 or 3, this is one incident yung kidnapping. This is the same incident that you relate earlier, yung mga nag-kidnap din nala sa Cotabato, tapos binalik po, kumain po sa bahay ng mga babae. Is that the same story, Mr. President?
No, that's not one.
There
was no police involved.
No police involved. So that's a separate.
They were policemen, and then they never tried to.
So, Mr. President, I will ask again. Itong case po ng kidnap and extortion, yung 2 to 3 policemen that you killed, were any cases filed?
Ano agan po?
Were any cases filed po dung 2 to 3 policemen na pinatay po ninyo involved with kidnapping and extortion?
Yung police na pinatay ko?
Yes.
Involved in kidnapping?
Yes.
Wala na kaso yan.
No more case. And
against,
like...
Against whom?
Against you po for having killed the policeman.
Ako?
Yes, Mr. President.
Bakit? Bakit magubayan ng kaso? Eh, may kasama akong police rin dyan eh. Hindi naman ako nagpapahiro. I'm not trying to picture myself as a crusader. Of course, magkasama ko yung mga police.
Sorry, Mr. President, perhaps mali po yung terminology, not filing the case in court, pero any case po yung for investigation
meron.
By the DOJ. Also meron po.
Meron.
So going back po, just to clarify, yung vigilante killings of 3 to 4 persons, likewise, meron rin pong investigation po with the DOJ. Okay, Mr. Chair, that clarifies it po.
Automatic yan, meron pa rin.
So filing the investigation, meron.
It's the police, but it's the fiscal will decide.
Yes.
Ang critical stage na is the fiscal.
Yes.
Whether or not there is a crime committed, or if there is a crime or an act committed, whether it is legal or illegal.
Thank you for the clarification, Mr. President.
Illegal, wala yan.
So earlier, yung binanggit po natin na 3 to 4 persons and then 2 to 3 persons of police, what I meant was fiscal po na investigation, not cases filed in court. At meron naman po. Likewise, Mr. President, yung pinatay po ninyo yung kidnapping incident, yung sa Cotabato, tapos bumalik, kumain sa bahay, paglabas, you confronted them, tapos pinatay po ninyo. Likewise, there was a investigation by the fiscal.
Yes.
And the case was dismissed.
Alam ko, pag binara sila ng police, yung laod, the owner of that laod thing, it was the laod, the police yan, the owner of laod firing range, yun ang pumapasok sa gitna, pinara sila. Tapos paglabas nila, may karbi na, nandito ako sa tabi.
Mr. President, was that SPO4 Jim Tan? Is that SPO4 Jim Tan, yung may-ari ng laod firing range?
Ang may-ari ng Laod doon, is Laod.
Ah, sorry. Ano po yung full name po niya, Mr. President, if you would recall?
Ano? Lewa.
So it was just Laod?
Laod?
Laod.
You can, you can easily get it by just phone.
Thank you, Mr. President. Mr. President, moving on with the next question po, no? Just a follow-up on the question by Congressman Manuel. In relation to the vetting of the drug matrix, you mentioned po earlier that in the initial drug matrix that you came out, there was no vetting involved. You said it was job of the police, yet there was a drug matrix that came from your office. Is that correct, Mr. President? If I am not mistaken, during the course of our investigation, there are allegedly 4 versions of your drug matrix.
Hindi ko na kuha yung tatanong mo.
Mr. President, I will rephrase. In the interpellation of Congressman Manuel, there was a talk about the drug matrix or yung narco list po ninyo. And you mentioned that it is the job of the police to vet. You do not vet. However, your office came out with its own drug matrix. So if it did not pass through the police, this underwent no vetting process. Is that a fair statement, Mr. President?
Vetting is a job of the law enforcement. It is shared by everybody. NBI, ipapasa yan. It's not only a requirement. It's their duty. Nagpapasahan kami ng information.
But Mr. President, yes, you mentioned that it would be the job of the PNP. So you mentioned now that it is coordinated with you. The PNP would coordinate that information with you.
Yes, as mayor. Correct.
Mr. President, we're talking about the drug matrix that you released as president, not as mayor. The one that you released upon assumption of your office in 2016.
Yes. What?
So this was vetted by the PNP. Was PIDEA involved, Mr. President?
I'm confused now. What's the question?
Mr. President, I'll rephrase. Particularly during your presidency, hindi na po nung panahon na kayo ay mayor. When you sat as president, you came out with a drug matrix. Now, I believe part of the interpellation of Congressman Manuel was that there was a question kung vetted po ito. Ang sabi po ninyo, hindi vetted. But now you're saying vetted naman po siya by the police, not by you. So you confirm po that, Mr. President?
Lahat ng listahan na dumadating sa akin, clear, binabasa ng baba yan, ng military, ng police.
And Mr. President, the PIDEA was involved in this initial list?
Of pagka-drugs, PIDEA talaga dapat.
I believe the drug matrix was used for the identification of yung mga HVT po ninyo, yung high-value target. So it is involved with drugs, so PIDEA should have been involved.
Yes, it's always the PIDEA who would be the agency to give us the information.
Mr. Chairman, Through the committee secretariat, may we know if DG Lazo is here with us today?
Yeah, I think we invited DG Lazo. I don't know if he also received the cancellation notice, but I saw him earlier at the ground floor. I just don't know if he's still here in the hall. Is DG Lazo, Paige, can you please check if DG Lazo is present? One-minute suspension. Hearing is resumed.
Thank you. Mr. Chairman, I'd like to direct my question to DG Lazo. DG Lazo, good afternoon po. Could you correct me if I'm wrong, DG Lazo, but as far as PDEO is concerned, in our previous hearings, you've mentioned that the drug matrix, when you were trying to trace the origins, dead end po kayo. The initial version, wala po kayong involvement.
Yes, Your Honor.
You mentioned there were four versions. Is that correct, DG Lazo?
Three versions. Your Honor.
And of these three versions, how many did PDEO participate in?
None, Your Honor.
None. So all three versions. And maybe know, I believe you had the timeline presented prior. One was 2016. The other was, would you give us a rundown of the dates, po, DG Lazo, please?
I do not have. Can I just refer to my?
Of course, please. Through the Honorable Chairman.
If you would allow, Your Honor, we have a PowerPoint presentation for this. We can have it flashed, but it will take a few minutes.
Mr. Through the Honorable Chairman, kung okay lang po, just mentioning of the dates lang po. We don't need the PowerPoint. Yung the date for the first version, the last date for the second version, the last and the date for the third.
The first list, Your Honor, is December 20 to 21, 2016. The second list came out on September 28, 2017. And the third list, Your Honor, came out on March 22, 2018.
Thank you very much, DG Lazo. And to confirm again, no participation on the part of PDEO for vetting these high-value targets?
None, Your Honor.
Thank you, DG Lazo. Mr. Chairman, I'd like to direct my questions to the former President again. Mr. President, sorry to disturb your eating. But I trust that you heard the testimony of DG Lazo. Ang sabi po niya, hindi po involved yung PDEO in all three versions of the drug matrix that you released. So kung hindi po PDEO yung nag-vet ng iyong drug matrix, sino po ito? You mentioned earlier, Mr. President, that the PDEA was involved.
Well, usually it is the PDEA. Yan talaga ang lead agency. But kung i-bypass sila ng mga police agencies, like the NBI or yung lower echelons, down the line to the municipalities, wala ba tayong magawa? It's not a mandatory rule that itong PDEA is always to be there.
Mr. President, I hope you'll forgive my confusion kasi po ang sabi po ninyo kanina, involved po yung PDEA. Now you're saying that it's not necessary, not a hard and fast rule that they're involved.
In what particular case are you referring to?
The drug matrix that you presented during your presidency, Mr. President.
I do not remember. You have to remind me of what that matrix is all about.
Well, Mr. President, sige po. Just to
if
simplify
there is na an inconsistency or it is incongruous, you tell me what, because that document might have been there. Matagal na ako hindi na presidente.
Mr. President, there's no allegation po of incongruency or any wrong in the drug matrix. We just are particularly interested in the vetting process of this document. We asked earlier kung sino po yung nag-vet. You mentioned it was an amalgamation of various agencies. PDEA just now said and affirmed that they were not involved. So I'll just make it simple, Mr. President. I'd like to ask, who prepared your drug matrix?
In what particular case?
The drug matrix, Mr. President.
No. Case to case yan eh. In what particular case?
Apologies, Mr. President. I don't understand what you mean particular case. When you sat, you assumed, you presented to the media a drug matrix which held all of the HVTs that you had.
Correct, but sabi ko, what particular case? You cannot make a general statement and ask me a general answer.
I think we're only referring to that one drug matrix, Mr. President.
I do not remember of any one matrix. There were so many matrix in my time as president.
Different variations at different times. Different matrices at different times. But I thought this was one continuing list, Mr. President. That nagdadagdag, nagbabawas. Hindi, is that not the case, Mr. President? Yung inyong drug matrix? You would have different matrices? Is that what you are telling us now?
Depende sa agency yung lumapit sa akin. It could be the CIS, it could be the NBI. Depende. Lahat ng law enforcement, it could be the customs police, kung may matrix sila, it's not one or two or three, it's a plenty.
So at the time of your presidency, you were presenting different matrices from different agencies.
Yes.
You did not have one master matrix.
Yeah.
Did you not use one master matrix for the PNP?
There are so many law enforcement agencies. Of course, yung PDEA is the lead agency, but they don't have a monopoly of making an arrest or an operation to go after the criminals. Ganun rin ang CIS or walang specific standard.
Mr. President,
kung sino lang makauna sa kanila.
Mr. President, if there are multiple matrices, how did you decide which one to read before your press conference? If I understand correctly, there should at least be one master list of the matrices. In fact, I remember one press conference in which you mentioned the
Talk
Mayor
slower, Mabito. Because I cannot understand you.
Oh, sorry.
Frankly, you're a lawyer?
Yes, Mr. President. I will talk slower.
Panero, you talk slower.
Okay.
Maybe maganda ka ang English mo, pero fortunately, hindi na iintindihan.
Thank you, Mr. President. I will slow down. So, Mr. President,
you are slurring your words. Yeah.
Mr.
I will follow. If that answers the question that you're answering, then maybe I got to hear you right. Ganon ang dating sa akin.
Mr. President, ang sabi po ninyo, you have multiple matrices from different agencies. However, when you conduct your press cons, you present them as one master list. Sometimes you would read from that master list the list of names, and I remember in particular, you had one press con in which you read the name of Mayor Jed Mabilo.
Yes.
So if you have one master list, which matrix is that, Mr. President, and who vets the master list?
That master list was there when I assumed the presidency. Kaya noon na presidente ako, lumayas yan. Kasi alam niya pa ko siya. Kaya bumalik. Ngayon na lang.
So, Mr. President...
Pero hindi na ako presidente, hindi ko na magpapakuhang.
Mr. President, there was one master list then, at the time of your assumption. Yet, there was updating through various agencies. Who was the agency in charge for putting them, merging into a master list?
PDEA talaga.
But Mr. President, PDEA said now that they have no participation in all three versions of the master list that you gave.
They have a master list. Hindi pwedeng hindi. Bobo itong mga gagantong, hindi nila ginawa yun.
Mr. President, if I may remind you to please refrain from using foul language para po hindi po mapunta sa record.
It's not. It's Bobo is actively Bobo. There's no other word for it, actually.
Just a reminder. So, please proceed.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Mr. Chairman, I won't belabor the point.
Mr. Chair, Mr. President, it's not Bobo, it's Gago. You said Gago a moment ago.
Sir. Mr. Chairman, may we move to delete the word JGO in the record of this Congress?
There is a motion to strike off from the record the word GAGO as pointed out.
I object, Mr. Chair. I would rather the word should be in the record.
1 minute suspension.
Correct. Tama yan.
Hearing is resumed. The parliamentary status is that there was a motion to strike off from the record the foul language used by the former president in his statement earlier, and it was objected by Congressman Benny Abante, and as he stated, he wants that particular word in the records of these proceedings. So may I know if Congressman Abante has a change of heart?
Mr. Chairman, upon the request of my colleagues, I would like to withdraw my objection.
Thank you. So there is now a motion to strike off from the record the statement made by the former president earlier, and it was duly seconded. Are there any objections? Hearing none, the motion is approved. So please continue, and you have 3 more minutes.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. Mr. Chair, it seems to be we have an impasse. The testimony of the former president, he insists that there was a list which was vetted by the PDEA, and if ever it was not vetted, it is their fault. However, the PDEA has now confirmed again what they have previously and consistently said, that the drug list never passed through their hands. So it begs the question, saan po galing yung master list ng former president po natin? Yet he does not recall, and he would not answer, which lead agency was involved with the preparation and the vetting. So I think this is another point that we would have to discover later on through other resource persons for the Quad. And I will no longer belabor that point. Mr. Chair, I'd like to move to my next question, given my limited time.
Mr. Chair, itong PDEA na ito, bago to. Hindi yan ang PDEA ko.
That is correct, Mr. President. This PDEA that was recently appointed after the former Director General Wilkins Villanueva.
Okay. Bago to. So, I don't know.
Thank you. Please proceed.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. Mr. President, just a few more questions given the time constraint. Mr. President, I'd like to ask about yung 2016 meeting, allegedly. And according to the testimony of Colonel Garma, you made a phone call to her asking about how to come up with a task force for the nationwide implementation of your supposed drug war. You mentioned earlier under questioning by Congressman Pimentel that Colonel Garma is lying, that you never had that conversation. And if I'm not mistaken, you said that she approached you with information as to drug suspects, and that, if I understand correctly, he called Leonardo to corroborate the same. Is that your statement, Mr. President?
Many times, hindi lang sila, lahat. Pero as to the statement of forming a unit, you cannot do that, because that would be a violation of policy and law regulation. It is only the police, national police, who can create units and whatever units that they want. Ang mayor walang pakialam talaga. It's out of yung gano. Maka-autos lang siya to do something. But he can supervise the activities of the police by, you know, requesting the assignment to people here and there. But you do not have the mayors now, the executives have no longer the control of the police.
Mr. President, just a clarification. This alleged meeting in 2016 was in preparation for the nationwide rollout of your drug war. This, you were no longer mayor, presidente na po kayo. And at this time, I believe that the PNP would be answerable to you. So it would definitely be within your powers to order the chief PNP to create a special unit in the same way that the chief PNP was answerable to you when you had him implement upland double barrel. So with that, Mr. President, seeing that it was within your power, if you willed it, that a task force be committed, that the task force be organized, it is very much possible po that you called Lieutenant Garma asking how to formulate this thing. I'm sorry, Mr. President, I just don't agree that you were powerless to create this task force. As far as this representation is concerned, it is well within your power. So with that, Mr. Chair, Mr. President, how do we reconcile now your statement that you never made that call to Garma to organize that task force, when Colonel Garma was able to give specific details about your call to her, about your meeting, in relation to finding a person to manage your drug war, in the person of Colonel Leonardo. This fact you stated on national television, I believe it was an interview with Attorney Panelo, in which you gave your reasoning for selecting someone of that religious affiliation. So, how can you say now, Mr. President, na hindi totoo yung affidavit ni Garma when there are bits and pieces of facts there that you yourself corroborated?
Bits and pieces naman kaya. It cannot be the whole of the affidavit that we're hearing now. Hindi ko maintindihan kung anong pinagsasabi niya.
But this
particular... I have not read the affidavit so that I would not be in a position to correctly really respond to your question. I am at a loss kasi ikaw yung may hawak ng... So you are now trying to investigate me. Para kang investigador, you may hawak ka ng affidavit dyan, executed by another person, and you're trying to confront me with the statements made in that affidavit, and you're trying to exact an answer from me. Pagka ganon, maghinto tayo dito. That is not proper.
Mr.
That
President.
Is not fair.
Mr. President, we're not...
Hindi, titindig ako dito. Bigyan mo muna ako ng...
Sir, spirit.
Yung mga affidavit, basahin ko before I answer you.
Suspended, sir.
Hearing resume. Go ahead,
thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Congressman Raj.
Mr. President, I will rephrase. Just to reiterate the context, this is not to confront you with the affidavit, but we want to reconfirm your statement with your interview with Attorney Panelo. Because, just for your information, Mr. President, we understand you do not have the affidavit now, but one of the bits and pieces that was relayed by Colonel Garma is that you contacted her looking for a person with a particular skill set and religious affiliation to help you manage and drive your drug war. Now, that fact you have corroborated in your interview with Attorney Panelo when you said that you were looking for a person of that religious affiliation because they are trustworthy with money. So I am now asking, Mr. President, with your corroboration in that interview, does that not jive with what Colonel Garma is saying?
It does not jive because I was looking for a particular person. Maybe a member of a sect, but it had to be one who has the brain and the balls to do the job.
So, Mr. President, if you were looking for a person to fill that position, what position did you have in mind? Was this your drug war czar?
No. May drug enforcement unit tayo sa gobyerno. It cannot be, they were there to just ask for an advice of how they would participate in the drug war. Hindi sila pwede mag-create ng unit because that is not allowed. It is only the police who can create a unit or a division. The mayors do not have that power.
Mr. President, I'm talking about this time you were already President Po, no?
Yes.
So, you were in a power to create that position. I'll just go back to your statement po, no, Mr. President. You said you were looking for someone with the smarts and the balls, sorry for the language, you were looking for someone of that capacity. Now, according to Colonel Garma, you were looking for that person to manage your drug war. But you are saying now that it is not to manage your drug war because you couldn't create that position.
It's your statement. Do not bind me with your statement.
No, I'm now asking, Mr. President, about your statement. Why were you looking for someone with the brains and the capacity? Ano po yung job, ano po yung trabaho na ibibigay mo po sana sa taong iyon?
Because drug money is alam mo, that is why we are not succeeding, because drug money is supporting the syndicate. madali ang pera. Nagpibigay ng pera yan. Huwag na tayo magbulahan dito. Kaya tayo hindi nagsasucceed kasi ang money, madali sa... madaling ibenta sa mga bata. And, you know, they bribe. Hindi tayo magulihan na tayo kung sino ang may... sino ang guilty, kung sino ano. Andito na tayo sa totoo. Huwag na tayo maglayo dyan sa totoo.
So, Mr. President, you are confirming that you were looking for someone to fill the shoes of a position related to the drug war because you are talking about drug money and how it corrupts people.
Yes, that is why. So that is why sinabi ko, Iglesia ni Cristo.
So,
kasi ang Iglesia ni Cristo, normally, hindi mo talaga makorrupt. Hindi natatanggap ng pera, alam ko, kasi mayor ako. You cannot easily corrupt a member of the Iglesia ni Cristo who is a policeman or soldier. Yan, that is the explanation.
Thank you for the clarification, Mr. President.
Yes, sir.
Mr. President, so in that case, tama po yung sinasabi ni Colonel Garma, in which you were looking for a person of that sect with those qualities to man your drug war. It's correct.
It's not man.
To manage your...
It's not man because it's man, it's meaning in command. Dalawang tao lang yung pinag-isipan mo. There is a drug unit in every department. Ano, command? They were there, Quran is... a special operation. Gusto nila, they were proposing something because na may nalaman sila kung mapasok dyan na droga dyan sa pier na yan. It is not a creating a command because you cannot do that. It belongs to the police hierarchy, if you may. Walang power ang mayor dyan.
Thank you, Mr. President.
Kaya, it was an operation. Sila yung nagsabi, meron kaming nalaman agad. O, sige, as mayor, I will support you. What would I refuse? Kung may naglapit dito na police, magsabi, sir, may nalaman kami dito na ito, we need this support. Sino boy, mayor na hindi mo? Eh, lalo na ako.
So, Mr. President.
Ako nga, pumapatay ng droga eh. Suporta pa sa police.
So, Mr. President, when you were looking for this person, in the person of Colonel Leonardo, although it was not to create a task force, it was for an operation which they were proposing. That is what you are telling us now, Mr. President.
Yes, because as I sabi ko, the corruption, madali. Madali and, sa law enforcement, corrupt. Kaya kailangan mo ang tao na ano, sabi ko yung mga iglesia ni Cristo, hindi mo madali-dali yan mabilit. That's the reason why.
Mr. President, this proposed operation, was this a nationwide scale drug operation?
No, I don't think so.
Would
parang
you
ano lang nila yun, but I suppose that it was not on that scale. Maybe yung ano lang yung pasok labas na ano. Or if it's an operation that you're asking as a drug syndicate.
Mr. President, I know we're pressed for time. Just one more question, if you would indulge. You mentioned in the Senate hearing that you had to have a distinction. You had the DDS, as you said, that the media would portray being the police. No, you mentioned some of your chief of police of Davao as being members of your death squad. But at another time, you mentioned you had a personal death squad na hindi po kapulisan. You mentioned, I think, at least you had 7 members here.
Well, as mayor, I was fighting crime. I was fighting the insurgents. Remember na, hindi mo lahat maano yung... it's Mindanao. The insurgents were active, the criminals are active. You cannot utilize all the policemen there. You have to have some mga civilians who were there in the insurgency na napasok sa iyo. That's a complicated matter. Pagka pumasok dyan, hindi mo alam yan. Yung police, iba yung trabaho nila, but there are activities there which you have to men from galing sa kanila. galing sa mga nag-surrender. Hindi mo kasi alam, diretso lang yung istorya eh. That is why it is good, mayroon tayo nito, that you I can clarify everything. Once and for all, wala man akong tinago, why would I form a, for what?
And I agree, Mr. President, we're here to clarify all of these
facts. Yes, sir. Exactly. I was responding to your question. Yes. Because, pardon me, it borders to sometimes, I will not use the word, sometimes in conclusion that borders in those.
Well,
may, mayor ako, presidente ako, ganun ako gagago. You think?
Mr. President, my next question in relation to that, that was just the predicate, the premise po, no? Na you had a personal
gago.
DBS.
Gago ako?
No, Mr. President, the question supposed to follow was that, could you name those seven people? Kung pwede nyo po ipangalan yung seven members ng DDS na yan po.
Members ng DDS?
Your personal civilian DDS, which you mentioned is apparently counter-insurgency force.
Apparently, you know, even if they exist, why would I tell you the names now, to you? Unting mo sa akin, stupido.
Mr. President, because we're in an investigation in aid of legislation, and we're ruling out that if they are in
mag-legislate kayo,
the drug war,
huwag mo mong isali dyan because I would be putting the people in danger. Yung inyong legislation, mine is law and order. We are far apart in our discussion dito. Biro mo, bigay mo yung pangalan mo, you put the family and the persons in danger.
Mr. President,
the proper question, ganon.
Can you please rephrase your question, Congressman Gutierrez?
Mr. President, with all due respect, the question of identifying these members was to really look into the purpose, because we're trying to differentiate now those that are within the bounds of law and those that are without, in relation to the drug war.
I'm sure that within the bounds of the law, and I take full responsibility. Huwag ka na maghanap ng iba. Ano yung 7-7 mo, dito ko nalang tutok sa akin. Ilan ko pang beses sabihin sa inyo, I take full responsibility. If you think that it is illegal or wrong, go ahead and file the case. I would be happy.
Ngayon, ikaw, bilang Pilipino, ano ang masasabi mo at reaksyon sa balitang ito? Mag-iwang ka ng komento sa ibaba at atin pong babasahin isa-isa.